One of the greatest threats we face as a species is the potential that Earth could get hit by an asteroid or comet. Not only do we have plenty of evidence that mass extinctions in the past have been caused by these kinds of impacts, we've also been faced with more recent, smaller but still frightening events like the Chelyabinsk meteorite fall or the Tunguska event that serve as reminders that we are still very much under the gun in this star system, and it's only a matter of time before something bigger comes our way. But asteroid impacts are avoidable even with current human technology, so long as we can see them coming ahead of time. In fact, we have a whole host of options for deflecting something like this before it's too late. The key to this, of course, is our ability to detect dangerous asteroids long before they hit, in order to give us enough time to deflect them. We already do this to a degree, and our detection abilities improve each year, and in fact, many potentially dangerous objects are already under active surveillance. A good development for sure, but so far, overall, we've just been lucky. We haven't been seriously hit during our time on this planet, and we do not yet see any immediate threats that would send us into panic mode, but it could happen at any time, and we are overdue. The good news is that as time goes on and we technologically advance, doing something about a potential impactor gets easier and easier, and someday it probably won't be a problem at all. But we still need to get to that day. But say we did detect a threat in the near term. How would we mitigate the threat? There are several ways. The first is very simple, nuclear weaponry. We tend to think of nukes as bad things, weapons for a war that no one wants to ever see. But like many things, nukes can also be a tool and could be used to deflect asteroids. To accomplish this, you would simply detonate the nuke on or near the asteroid. For an asteroid that is relatively solid, you don't necessarily need to completely destroy it. Rather just nudge it in a different direction. In fact, you would want it to stay as intact as possible. Rubble could be a bad thing. Rather, you just want vaporized ejecta pushing the asteroid in a slightly different direction so it misses Earth. Some asteroids, however, are little more than conglomerations of loose rubble. Here you would want to detonate a series of nukes at more of a distance to nudge the asteroid without turning it into a hazardous cloud of rocks still on an Earth intercept course. Other possibilities include detonating a subsurface nuke inside the asteroid to nudge it, or building a cradle containing several nukes around the asteroid and detonating them that way. But the nuclear option isn't the only option. Also possible with current technology is a simple impactor. Any object sufficiently large, say another asteroid, or an impactor sent from Earth, could knock an asteroid off course enough to have it miss Earth. Say we positioned a mass driver to fire materials or moon rocks at the object. We already have some experience with this method. The Deep Impact mission sent a projectile to impact the comet Temple 1 in 2005. While this was designed to blast a crater in the comet to study its interior rather than to actually perturb it, it was a success and demonstrated that objects in space can be targeted and struck. Future missions promise to expand on this by the European Space Agency to study and even attempt to deflect an asteroid. More, ESA has determined that it might be possible to deflect the asteroid Apophis, one of the more spooky near-Earth asteroids, with as little as a one-ton impactor. But there are other options. If you have ample time, you might also deflect an asteroid using gravity. The main advantage to this method is that you don't create any debris, and you don't have to worry about how fast the asteroid is spinning. You're simply using a massive object's gravity and propulsion to very slowly pull an asteroid into a different orbit. Disadvantages are that you would need a seriously large object to have enough of an effect, and costs are also much higher for this approach, and it takes time, at least several years to decades for a massive spacecraft with an ion drive to tug the asteroid in a different direction. Or even mount a conventional rocket engine on the asteroid and push it that way. Another method would be to concentrate solar energy on the surface, causing material to evaporate and push the comet or asteroid in a different direction. But this suffers from the need of some seriously large lenses, basically megastructure lenses. Other more novel options include wrapping the asteroid in a reflective material, or painting it, essentially turning it into a makeshift solar sail, or aerobraking the object by putting material in its path and changing its course. One simple way would be to change the balance of the asteroid by moving its center of mass through a tether and ballast. You might even be able to accomplish this by constructing such a rig from material originating from the asteroid itself. One final proposition would be to use a laser array at Earth to move the asteroid by vaporizing surface material to nudge it without actually having to visit the object at all. This plan is known as D-Star or DE-Star, put forth by Philip Lubin and a group at the University of California at Santa Barbara, linked to their website below, that proposes an extremely powerful multi-use modular laser array that not only could deflect an asteroid, but completely vaporize it. Such a system would have more uses than just deflection, however. It could also be used to clear orbital debris around Earth, push solar sails to very high speeds, opening the way for interstellar travel, and shortening times for a trip to Mars to as little as 3 days. Also, such a system would be of immense use in asteroid mining, as it would allow interested parties to prospect an asteroid before even traveling to it. By vaporizing materials from the asteroid's surface, the composition could be determined from Earth, and then it could be decided whether something is worth mining or not. Further, asteroids could be manipulated and moved around the solar system with the laser for easier mining or other projects, such as beaming energy around to colonies. Perhaps most interestingly, however, is the potential for very long-distance laser communications, and this aspect holds potentially major implications for SETI. At the energies required for this system to be able to deflect asteroids, the energies involved here are on level with a space shuttle solid rocket booster, it would be extremely bright. In fact, for most of the exoplanets we know of so far, it would appear as one of the brightest objects in their sky at the frequency of the laser. Given enough time for the light to propagate, this might even be visible on intergalactic scales. Given the utility of such an array, aliens probably need to move asteroids too. Planetary defense systems like D-Star might be among the most common things alien civilizations build and count as a very visible potential technosignature for future SETI searches. And in the end, planetary defense is planetary defense. Most of the things we'd defend against would be natural objects heading our way, but if anyone ever decided to send a hostile von Neumann probe or the like towards us, we would have two lines of defense: space nukes and giant vaporizing space lasers. Thanks for listening. I'm futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently worried about alien space lasers. What if we find one? In one sense, it would be a detection of an alien civilization, but in another sense, it would be a cat-like fascination with a galactic equivalent of a laser pointer. I can hear the aliens snickering at us already, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.